Dear student, assalamu alaikum. I hope all of you are fine by the grace of Almighty Allah. Dear student, I am Mohammad Shahjahan, Assistant Professor, Department of Accounting, Milestone College, Uttara, Dhaka.
Dhaka. Dear student, this is our first lecture on Chapter 5. Dear student, this is Accounts. Dear student, after this lecture, you can able to explain the concept and features of accounts. You will be able to keep accounts by using different types of table. You can able to classify accounts as per accounting equation. You can able to record debit and credit in related accounts as per double entry system. Dear student, let's come to class. Accounts. An account refers to asset, liabilities, income, expense, and equity as represented by individual ledger pages to which changes in value are chronologically recorded with the debit and credit entries. These entries referred to as posting become part of a book of final entry or ledger. Dear student, that means account refers, account discuss, accounts tell us about asset, liabilities, income, expense, and equity. That means five main things. In an organization, what about the asset, what are the liabilities, what about the income, expense, and equities are expressed with the help of accounts, different head of accounts. Dear student, that means cash account, purchase account, sales account, furniture account, building account. These are the example of different types of accounts. Some are assets, some are liabilities, some are income, some are expense, and some are equities. So I hope all of you understand what is accounts. Then two types of account table are used in accounting. Dear student, in accounting we are using two types of table. Number one, T-table. And T-table, these types of table are divided into two parts. That means like a T, this table is divided in two sides. One side is debit and in another side it is credit. That's why it is called T-table. In each part there are four columns. How many columns? Four columns. So in a T-table format, how many columns? It is 8 columns. Dear student, important MCQ. In a T-table format, we have 8 column. In debit side we have 4, in credit side we have 4. Total number of column in is 8. Balance, difference of debit side and credit side is determined at the end of a specific time of period. Dear student, another important MCQ question, balance. What is balance? Difference of debit side and credit side of an account. That means if debit side it is 10,000, if it is credit side 8,000, that means debit balance is 2,000. That means debit side is greater than credit side by taka 2,000. That means balance means difference of debit and credit. T-table format. Dear student, this is a format of T-table format accounts. Account title at first we have to write, then accounts code like cash account, then accounts code, it is the as per the business. Then debit side, credit side. In debit side we have date, particular, JF, taka. Again in the credit side, date, particular, JF, taka. That means we have two equal sides. In one side we have to write date, particular, JF, taka. In another side we have to write date, particular, JF, taka. This is a format of T table. Then moving balance table. Dear student, earlier I have told you that we can prepare accounts by two methods. Number one, T-table, and number two, moving balance table. It is another name, modern format. One column of is for date, particular, and JF. In this format, we have one column for date, one column for particular. Earlier, T-table, in debit side, one column for date, in credit side, one column for date. See, but in moving balance format, we have one column for date, one column for particular, and JF, journal folio. Total four column for amount. For amount, we have four column. An important MCQ, dear student, how many column? for writing amount in moving balance format. It is 4. Total number of column is 7. In T table format it is 8, and in moving balance format we have 7. The balance difference of debit side and credit side is determined after posting each transaction. Another important difference from moving balance to T balance, T table. In T table, at the end of the time, at the end of the month, we have to find out the balance. But in moving balance format, difference of debit side and credit side is determined after posting each transaction. That means after every transaction, we are getting the balance. That's why it is called moving balance. That means the balance is moved for every transaction. And debit and credit amount column situated side by side. Debit and credit, there is no two side. It is situated one by one. Dear student, the format of moving balance: account title, account code, then date, particular, JF. These three common column, and then debit taka we have to write here, credit taka we have to write here, then balance, debit balance, credit balance. So total number of column is 7, and there is no two side, debit side, credit side. Debit is situated side by credit. Dear student, now types of account. Types of account, important thing, dear student. Types of account, in the definition we have get some idea about types of account. Look at, there are 5 types of account: asset, liabilities, equities, revenue and expense. Asset, liabilities, equities, revenue and expense. We have 5 types of account, dear student. There are how many types of account? 5 types of account: asset, liabilities, equities, revenue and expense. Then debit credit. Dear student, most important thing from this chapter, how we can find the debit credit of these different types of account. Formula for determining debit and credit. Name of account, asset. Dear student, just before we have learned that there are 5 types of account: asset, liability, equity, revenue and expense. Asset, if it is increase, debit; decrease, credit. Liabilities, decrease, debit; increase, credit. Equity, decrease, debit, increase, credit. Revenues, decrease, debit, increase, credit. Expense, increase, debit, decrease, credit. So dear student, it is easy to memorize. We have to memorize, this is a must. Asset and expense, look at asset and expense, same behavior: increase, debit and decrease, credit. On the other hand, liability, equity and revenue, look at, for decrease debit and increase it is credit. So dear student, now it is easy. Asset and expenses, increase debit, income, liabilities and equities, revenues, liabilities and equities, increase credit, decrease credit, debit, just opposite of asset and expenses. I hope you can memorize, and if you cannot memorize, you cannot go ahead. Dear student, this formula is very important for us. I hope inshallah by next class all of you will memorize this formula. Dear student, now assessment. Dear student, after this lecture, in the we have some time in the class, so by this time you will write some example of asset. Dear student, you know what is asset. Asset means the things belongs to us and will give us service for long time. So you will write some example of asset, like furniture, building, machinery, etc. All of you will write at least 10 asset name. Then write example of liabilities. That means liability means we are bound to pay. That means if we are liable to pay to anybody, then it is our liability, like a loan, like purchase on credit. So these are the liabilities. You will write at least 10 example of liabilities. Then write some example of equity. You know that, dear student, equity means money of owner. Money of owner, that means whatever money supplied by owners is called equity. So you will write some example of equity. You will write only 5 example of equity. Then, dear student, you will write some example of revenue. Revenue means income. You know that sales is the number one income. So there are some other income like interest on investment, commission received, discount received. So you will write at least 5 revenues. Then last one is write some example of expenses. Dear student, expense means we paid and get service for short time. So you will write some example of expense. Dear student, this is your homework. You will do at home.